Hello and welcome to Love at First Sniff. What could Love at First Sniff possibly be? Well, a doggy wedding, of course.
Joining the love of two wonderful dogs, say hello to Charlie and Louie.
Meet Charlie. She's a Bichon Maltese Shih Tzu cross and 5 years old. She likes treats, walks, and sniffing new things, and allergic to chicken. Charlie's looking for someone to boss around. Now let's meet Louie. He's a Maltese Chihuahua and 7 years old. He likes treats, running, and younger ladies, and has no allergies. Louie's looking for someone to dance with.
It's a long journey of how these two precious pups fell in love, but we're going to start with how they met, their health and grooming regime in preparation for their big day, the honeymoon, and of course, the wedding ceremony. We're not the first to have a doggy wedding. Over in New York, they broke the Guinness World Record for the most expensive pet wedding ever. It was $158,187.26. First, we follow how Charlie and Louie met. Tindog, a way more adorable version of Tinder. Tindog is a dating app for, yes, you called it, dogs.
You can use Tindog to find dogs in your area. Simply swipe left for no or swipe right for yes.
Although Tindog isn't only for finding love. If your dog is already happily single or already has a puppy in crime, then it's great for finding friends. With over 100,000 users, Tindog doesn't only match your dogs, but also the owners. Still to come, we're going to show you how to keep your dog in its best health before his or her big day.
Moving pets can be stressful for both you and your furry feathered friends. PetBus can help you move your precious cargo nationwide. Transport your pet stress-free with a professional company who cares. Contact PetBus now. Dog Rescue Dunedin Charitable Trust rescues dogs and provides them with veterinary care, food, and home-based foster care. The goal is to find them forever homes. Open your heart and home to a friend for life and help support Dog Rescue Dunedin today.
Welcome back. Previously on Love at First Sniff, we talked to Tindog and Parks, finding the perfect match for your lonely dog and even yourself. Now let's talk health. Keeping your dog healthy leading up to its big day can be a difficult task. Radical Dog Food Company has the right biscuits for you. Let's take a look.
My name is John Newlands. We live in North Otago and I've been farming for 50 years. So this is a new venture for us. Primarily it came about is because we have the only commercial tart cherry orchard in New Zealand. And at harvest time, our farm dogs, along with our companion pet Maggie, would come along and eat all the cherries that fall on the ground during harvest. The first year we never really picked up on it, but it was the second year we realised, gee, these dogs have got vitality they never had before. Then we realised we had something. So then we thought, how do we put the cherries into food for the dogs? That's how it started. For a start, we had to try and find an animal nutritionist who would put together a formulation that we wanted for the dog biscuits. And that wasn't easy, because a lot of them said it couldn't be done. But we finally found a lady who said, I'll give it a go, but it's going to take a long time to do it. So we got started. And then we sent, after we made a batch, we would send it up to Massey University to be tested. And that went on for a number of years. In fact, the whole procedure took just over 5 years from the time we started until we had a product suitable for sale. My wife, Maureen, and myself went to Lincoln University, and it was a bit like my kitchen rules. We had to make all these batches of biscuits in front of all the food technicians and surveyed a bit. And at the end of it, they told us there was no machine in New Zealand that could make our biscuits. So that was fairly daunting. So finally we went home and we designed and manufactured our own machine to make the biscuits because of the composition of the dough. Montmorency tart cherries is what they're primarily made from, a pack full of high antioxidants along with a lot of other health promoting materials. In the Northern Hemisphere, they are known as a healing fruit. So luckily for us, we have developed a unique formulation to process the biscuits where they've maintained the high antioxidant levels, which are very, very good at destroying free radicals in the dog's body. Example, joint mobility, arthritis, coats, the skins, but mainly it brings back the vitality. But mainly we have Montmorency tart cherries and also Montmorency tart cherry concentrate. Now, everything we use in the biscuits is of human grade quality, and even the cherries are all number ones. We don't have any seconds at all. So it's highest quality food. If they visit our website, they will find a lot of retailers who stock it. Our website is www.radicaldog.co.nz. It's so nice to hear people who either ring or write into us to say how well their dogs are doing. A lot of people have had their dogs on medication for 6 to 12 months. It's made a difference to dogs. Once they've been taking Radical Dog biscuits for 2 to 3 weeks, they can't believe. And we're getting testimonials all the time. It's fantastic. Well, there's one of the biscuits that we have. They're approximately 10 grams each. And as I said, if you want for a health supplement, you want to feed one biscuit per 4 kilograms of body weight daily, you'll see fantastic results. The biscuits can actually be broken in half for a treat, ideal for dog training. Brilliant. Our policy is, it saves on a brochure and on a website. If your dog doesn't like them, they send them back. We refund the money for the bag, no questions asked at all. Because dogs like humans, not everybody likes certain products, but we can guarantee it. The reason it is so successful is all the dogs love it, and the owners see the results, how well their dogs look and how much vitality they've gained. We think it's, and we know it's absolutely brilliant, because we're getting testimonials every day, people saying, wow. And one gentleman even said, it was a miracle in a bag. And when you have people coming back all the time, repeat orders, that gives you a lot of confidence that you have hit the nail on the head. And we know we've got a very special biscuit that we produce in New Zealand for New Zealand dogs.
Did you know, dog owners in the US spend over $8.6 billion on dog food in only 1 year? I shit you not.
And now we're off to Murray's veterinary clinic to talk teeth and doggy dental health.
So my name's Kate, and I've worked out here at Murray's Veterinary Clinic for 6.5 years now. So I started out fresh out of Polytech as a junior nurse, just loving anything to do with animals. I was really enjoying the variety I got to see here with the small and large animals. One thing that I've always been really interested in though is dental health, so I'm always still interested to have a wee poke down if they're doing any dentals, to have a wee look and see what's going on in their mouths, and you know, making sure we've got some good products. So it is really easy to check your dog's teeth. What I normally recommend is coming from above, and then you can use your wee thumb here to pull up his wee side of his gum, and then you can just slightly pull his wee cheek out, and so then you can see right down all those teeth there. If Louie had a sore tooth or he was having teeth problems, you'd smell. It would be a different, funkier smell. Generally, dog's breath shouldn't smell. It does have a bit of an odour, but if it was really smelling, that would be normally the first sign. Another one would be that he might be reluctant to eat his dinner. So normally, I imagine Louis loves his tucker. If he was a bit like, he was holding off, he really wanted to eat it, but you know, he saw he was dropping his bickies out and back into his bowl, that could mean that he would have a wee sore tooth. Sometimes we see dogs that they'll paw at their mouth, they brush the side of their mouth with their tooth because it's sore. If you don't want to be doing bones or you don't want to be doing a special dental diet, then we generally recommend that you at least use a biscuit. Just do a biscuit diet, because that's going to get that toothbrush effect on them. Your softer foods like dog rolls, they tend to leave, since it's soft, it's acting like a sticky kind of residue on their teeth, so it's allowing that plaque to stay on there and not get brushed off. That is what makes that smell when they breathe on us, which is not the best when you're getting married, Louie. You don't want to be giving your bride smelly kisses. It does flow on, you know, the overall house. So we've seen many animals, dogs and cats, that have had poor dental health, and you know, it's made them quite sick, and they'll come in, you know, even a week or so later after having those rotten teeth removed and having all that plaque taken away, and they feel so much brighter because they're not being held back by feeling sick with all that bacteria. So Murray's Veterinary Clinic, we're quite unique in that we have open clinics. So these are times where you can bring your small animals, so small pets, out for a consultation with our vet without making an appointment. So we hold those Monday to Friday mornings, 9 till 10 in the mornings, and Monday through to Thursday evenings, 7 till 7:30. So this is an opportune time where you can bring them along and get them seen by a vet to get their teeth checked out and see what else is going on. If Louis was wanting to get spick and span for his up-and-coming wedding, so there is quite a variety of things you can do for your dogs. There's a few different enzyme treatments that stop that bacteria building up in their mouth, stops that smell. The different dental chews and like additives that you can put in their water to help the breath smell fresher and help that dental disease. But I would say, Louis, that it's probably best that you do get a dental before getting married, just to make it nicer for Charlie. So this is Charlie, Louis's bride-to-be, and as you can see, she's got her haircut sorted, looking beautiful as can be. So we're just going to check her teeth, because any dog's teeth can be different. Regardless of age, dental disease affects all our pets, so it is really important that we don't just pick on old dogs thinking that their teeth might be worse, because quite often young ones can have dental problems too. So if we just check in here, she's got a lovely fluffy beard there, but you can see, just since she was a wee bit worried with me putting my hand over the top of her head, I can just use my bottom hand and I can see those front teeth there. So she's got a wee bit of yellow built up on there, a wee bit of plaque, but not too bad. Don't forget, Charlie, it's all about you on the day, so feel beautiful and pampered, get a groom, have a nice toothbrush and nice meal on the morning so you feel energised and ready for the day to see Louis at the end of the aisle.
Charlie must be glad Louis doesn't have stinky doggy breath anymore, aren't you, Charlie? I wouldn't want to be kissing that on my wedding day. Murray's Veterinary Clinic in Mosgiel are also supporters of bandanas that use traffic light colours to help you recognise what kind of dog you're dealing with. Still out at Murray's Veterinary Clinic, part of their business is canine chic pet grooming. Charlie and Louie got pampered for their special day.
My name's Amy, I'm one of the groomers here at Canine Chic. And I've been grooming for about 8 years now. I've just loved animals. I've always wanted to be in the animal industry, and I'm just very passionate about presentation and, you know, and helping authors are helping animals. Well, for health benefits, number one. I mean, it's not just the coat, but it's the skin as well. I mean, the skin needs to be able to breathe, and if the dog is matted, that affects its health. We also, you know, being a groomer, because we're touching the dog all over, we can check for any lumps and things like that. And we generally might sort of like notice their teeth and things like that when we're trimming around their mouths. So it's just health benefits all over for the dog. We'll explain to the owners what sort of would be needed for their dog's breed, because every coat is different. So it just depends again on the breed, and we ideally like to see them to be able to give you a sort of detailed instruction on how to care for the coat. We will do around their bottoms, their feet, and around their face especially. If people want specific breed trims, we will do a breed cut for the dog. A lot of people just like them sort of short and tidy, and we can do that, and they'll get bathed, they get nails done as well. So they're pretty much getting all over a spritz and pamper. And the end, we've also got these dog colognes as well. They get a nice smell at the end as well. I mean, generally, every dog breed needs grooming at some stage of its life, whether it's short coat or if it's long and fluffy. But generally these dogs, they should be sort of groomed between 6 and 8 weeks, just to keep the coat maintained and mat free. I mean, it's a lot of work, some of these hairy breeds, to keep them combed at home, and a lot of the times owners can't deal with it, so that's what we're here for. Definitely find a pet safe shampoo. You get them at your vets or pet stalls or anything like that. But yeah, definitely don't use your human shampoos on them because they can have skin reactions and things like that. I mean, pet shampoos are made especially for your animal. My favourite trick is don't wet the head first, because when you wet the head, the dog will shake and give you a bath at the same time. We have done a couple of wettings. Hair dyeing is one that to be quite popular, and also nail painting. We do that, we do offer that as a service. So if that's sort of what you like, we can do that. Each groomer's got their sort of own style. So everyone sort of cuts a little bit differently to each other, but generally we sort of have our sort of standard trim that we sort of cater to each dog, depending on the face structure and things like that. Again, this is a health thing as well, if keeping the eyes here clean, it sort of stops it from getting wet, and they can cause sort of skin irritations and things like that as well. Good boy, Libby. Oh, you're a good model.
Canine chic pet grooming isn't just for the bridal groom. If you're a guest, or if you want to take that perfect picture for your doggy Tinder, or even looking flawless around home, you don't need a reason to look great. Both Charlie and Louie look fantastic for their wedding day. All Charlie needs now is a doggy tiara. In fact, the most expensive doggy tiara is a 250-carat emerald and diamond tiara worth $4.2 million. Sorry, Charlie, but I don't think you'll be wearing this anytime soon. After the break, yes, the wedding ceremony is finally here.
Moving pets can be stressful for both you and your furry feathered friends. PetBus can help you move your precious cargo nationwide. Transport your pet stress-free with a professional company who cares. Contact PetBus now. Dog Rescue Dunedin Charitable Trust rescues dogs and provides them with veterinary care, food and home-based foster care. The goal is to find them forever homes. Open your heart and home to a friend for life and help support Dog Rescue Dunedin today.
Welcome back. So far, we've found out how Louie and Charlie met and their health and grooming regime. Now, we have the guests coming off Pet Bus, the bus that transfers your pets anywhere you need. And now, the moment that we've been waiting for, the wedding ceremony.
Everybody. Hello and welcome to what is truly a unique and remarkable occasion. Clearly the love that Louie and Charlie have for each other is very genuine, despite the briefness of their relationship, and it thrills me to see so many of you here to celebrate this wonderful occasion. Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, the entrance of the bride. Are we ready for some bow wow vows? Louie Anderson, Charlie Hickel, do you promise to love each other as lifetime partners in marriage, with fleas or without, sharing walks together, and never fighting over scraps of food or bones?
Now, logistically, of course, an exchange of wedding rings in the absence of fingers presented a bit of an issue today, but after putting our heads together, we came up with what we thought was quite a good alternative. And we will be exchanging dog biscuits in lieu of rings. Can I briefly say, ladies and gentlemen, these biscuits are perfect rectangles. They represent stability, symmetry, and balance. these biscuits symbolize the perfection of the love that Louis and Charlie have for each other. In joining the families together, I will ask first the owners of the groom to present a biscuit to the bride. Maybe later. Okay. And die owner of the bride, if you would like to present a biscuit, please, to the groom. Oh, no, I think, well played though, well played by Louis, good form. He realises that the bride declined her biscuit and perhaps they'll share them together later on the honeymoon perhaps. So we're almost finished and before we conclude, we just have some paperwork to complete and then with great pleasure I can well and truly pronounce Louis and Charlie a happily married couple.
Louis and Charlie, congratulations. You are now husband and wife. Louis, you may now sniff your beautiful bride.
That's a wrap.
The happy couple are finally married. Now we're on to the luxurious honeymoon at Goodwood Kennels.
My name's Claire Wellington. We're in Goodwood, which is somewhere that most people know. It's a very small place. We're between Palmerston and Waikawaiti, and we are very close to central Otago. I take care of dogs and cats. And try to give them a comfortable stay and a happy time when they're not with their families. We were teaching and I figured that I wanted to find out if I could do anything else. So and there's a lot of things similar about running a kennels and teaching, I found out. And so transferable skills, beautiful place, get to be with dogs all the time. And I find that animal people are really nice people to spend time with and to work with. So I think it's the best of everything, really. We are licensed to have 60 dogs. We have 12 different enclosures. I take a lot of time to make sure the dogs are with compatible dogs. It's important to me that we can move them if they're not happy, try out different combinations just so that they're matched the right kind of space and the right energy from the other dogs. You can see when they're happy and when they're comfortable. What they find here is that there's a routine and it's reliable and it's enclosed. Because for some animals they will try and find their owners and people's properties aren't as secure as perhaps they thought they were. And once they've been and they've tried it and they realise the dogs are happy and that it actually isn't a scary place and they aren't likely to be attacked by other dogs, which I think is somebody's worry, or that they'll be cold or they'll be uncomfortable. Once they've had that experience, then they realise that it's the safest place for them to be. And for me, the biggest compliment is when someone comes back and says they didn't worry about their dogs at all, they didn't have to think about them. And I, as a dog owner myself, I know that's a huge relief because they're important, they're precious, and you want them to be You want them to be safe and happy. If we can do that, that's what I like to do. I think for a lot of people it's trusting that someone else will take care of their animal the way they like to, and that they'll know their animal well enough as an individual, because they're all different. And I think that it's important to try and find out what that difference is and what might be the small thing that makes a difference to that dog. And I always ask that question on the form: is there anything else you'd like me to know? Is there something you think would make give them a better stay, or help me to take care of them specifically for their needs? And it's the unknown, I think, as well, especially if you haven't been here and you look on the website, it looks okay. So you think, I'll check it out. But I encourage people to come and visit, and also to bring their dogs for a play date. So then they get to experience what it's like. They get to run on the paddock. They get to find out that this is actually a pretty cool place to be, that there's freedom. I mean, it's secure, so they can run wild. And for some of them, you can see they haven't done that for a while. They're usually on a lead, perhaps, or they haven't been out in the company of other dogs and had that much fun. So I think that's important. And also, if you bring them for a day, you collect them at the end, the dog knows it's not moving to a new home. Because if you leave it drive away with the rest of the family and the dog's here, he doesn't know whether you're going to come back. He might think that's his new home. So I encourage people to do that. But we do the natural thing here. And some dogs have a whole new world open up to them because they've never been exposed to it, and they love it. Yeah. It's interesting, we have people who drive past, we have a sign on the highway, and of course it's a main highway, so people will have seen it. They might be going somewhere else and thinking about something else, but they'll say when they call, yeah, we've noticed that you were there, so we thought we'd look on your website. Of course, that's and people will Google. We're well known locally. This place has been here for 30 years, I think. It started a very long time ago. So there is and it's a dog owning area. People have pets. In fact, people have multiple pets in this just local area, so Karatani and Waikawaiti, Palmerston. And then, of course, we're on the turning to the pig route there. So people will use us because they're going inland. And I think we're cheaper as well. People find us because if they're coming from Christchurch to Dunedin or Invercargill, or they're going somewhere else, it's cheaper to leave your pet here than it would be back in Christchurch. In fact, almost anywhere. In fact, I think cheaper than most places in Dunedin. So it is another reason people come. You can see their dogs and the cats. They're beautiful to spend time with. They're beautiful to watch. They're just the joy that comes out of them when they're happy. And it's a momentary thing maybe, but it's worth it. It's worth it. I think they should come here because the dogs have so much space and because they get to go to the paddock twice a day. And people just think that's just ordinary, but it's not ordinary if you're a dog. It's fantastic if you're a dog. They love it. They think about it. They wait for it. They get to explore or sniff or chase or play or jump in the pool. So many of them love to just jump in the pool, and they get to just busy around with each other. And it's real freedom, real joy, and dogs deserve that. They need it.
Guests are also welcome to stay with the two lovebirds at this great getaway. Thanks to Petbus for getting us to the honeymoon suite, and to the guests who came along for the trip. So we've had the wedding, and the honeymoon at Goodwood Kennels is all over. It's time to send our best wishes to Charlie and Louie. Thanks for watching. Tune in next time, because there might be a new couple wanting to share a bone. I'm Jasmine Ning. Have a pawsome day.